fouled off the boards. Here comes Dustin Brown, and that didn't get all the way through. And the puck is cleared ahead. It hit off of one of the Coyotes. Didn't come out of the zone. Here's Dustin Brown with it. Had his stick chopped out of his hand. Oh, the penalty now being called. Referee at center ice put his hand up late.
Well, the stick is broken. That's why Brown put his hands up right away.
Yeah.
The stick was chopped for sure, and it broke in half. It broke so high up on the handle that people didn't notice, I think. And then Brown finally dropped it, and he is going to draw the penalty there. But we also have Lewis who's
There might be another penalty on the hit on Lewis, too.
Hey, watch Brown coming in here. He's got his head up. There's the chop, and he goes right away because it is broken about 4 or 5 inches down from the top of the stick. Then Lewis protects himself, and he turns around. That one hurt.
Okay, let me ask you this question. And Doan's coming at him, and he's facing Doan. Why would he turn and put himself in that position and face the boards at the last second, though?
Well, you know what? I think they're tossing Shane Doan.
Well, if it's a boarding call and you're cut, then it's an automatic five-minute major.
I think that's exactly what's happening.
What a turn of events here.
Because Shane Doan's reaction when he got near the box was, what? Are you kidding me? Yeah, and Lewis does turn around.
Yep. And once the numbers are there, you know, Shane Doan is focused on the body. But there's the turn, and now Doan doesn't have time or doesn't react in terms of trying to stop or hug him or just kind of blend into it. And it ends up, but Lewis, boy, he puts himself in a bad spot right there.
I agree. And he hit his nose right on the dasher. He was right at that level because he was bent over so far. You have to feel for Shane Doan, too, because we showed it to you in slow motion.
Yes, that's right, Brian. When that happens quick, Lewis is facing and then spins and turns. And now the numbers are right at Shane Doan, who's coming in. Obviously, looking as well at the play that happened, there's going to be a minor penalty. Doan's on the right side. Now he's facing, then he turns.
Yeah, that's really a tough call. But you know what happens there, too? When you think about the referees, they're looking at Dustin Brown, and Dustin Brown with his hands in the air and deciding, okay, that is going to be a penalty for slashing. Then all of a sudden, you see a guy go down. You can see it was a hit from behind. And then Lewis gets up, and he's bleeding from the nose and from the face.
Well,
the boarding penalty comes out. It draws blood, and you can see how the referees kind of piece things together. I'm not so sure they saw everything happen exactly the way we just did, and it cost Shane Doan the rest of the game.
So Lanco got the 2 minutes for slashing. Doan gets the five-minute major, and he's out for the rest of the game. There's still 29 seconds remaining in the Yandel penalty, so I believe the Lanco minor penalty will not start until the Yandel penalty expires.
That's right.
And Yandel will not be able to come out of the box then until there is a stoppage in play. So it's a 5-on-3, and the Coyotes win this draw as the puck goes out to center ice.
Well, Coyotes' motto has been bend but don't break. This is be a true test right here with the adversity that they're facing and what they put themselves into right now.
Here is Carter now.